Hello?
Mr. Millard?
Yeah, this is George Millard.
How are you today?
I'm doing fine.
Yes, sir. My name is Mohammed Ahmed, and my wife recently came to your, you have the fruit vegetable stand?
Mm-hmm.
And purchased some, I believe you call, what you call turnip, they were leafy.
Turnip greens, is that what you call them?
Yes, turnip greens. And it was a very large sack when she got home. And we don't know much about the American cooking, but when she finished cooking all of them, it got down to, it was just a little tiny bowl. And we had thought, you know, that we would have the same amount as in the sack, you know, a large amount.
Well, I mean, I sell them by the bunch is the way I sell them.
Yes, sir. But what I mean is...
lay down and you put them in a pot and steam them, or, you know, and cook them. They'll cook down.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I did not realize that, and they were all upset because there was not enough for everyone to eat.
I see. Well, what can I do to help?
Well, is there any way you could, you know, to sort of compensate us for that? Maybe we could...
I mean, you bought it by the bunch, and that's the way they're... I mean, I've sold turnip greens for the last... well, since 1986 here.
Yes, sir.
When you buy the greens as they are. And they cook down. You can go to, I mean, I don't know what you, you know, you would have cooked them right after you bought them.
Yes. Oh, yeah, we did. Yeah. We did. You know, since we didn't really get enough to eat from that, what could I maybe come, and we love tomatoes. Could you maybe give us a basket of tomatoes at no charge?
You're the first one I've ever had to do that, but no, I'm not. I mean, I sell a nice bunch of turnip greens.
Could you maybe just give us like a melon, like a watermelon or something, any place of it?
They're out of, you bought them and you paid for them, and you got what you bought and paid for. I'm not going to give you anything.
Well, what I'm saying is it... what I'm saying is that it looked like a whole lot, you know, and we thought we would...
like it, but when you cook greens, they cook down. That's what I'm telling you. You can get them, wilt them, whatever you want to do, but they go down dramatically.
Well, how many would we have to get to have enough to eat?
Well, I don't know how many people you're trying to feed or how hungry you are.
Well, we have about 10 or 12 people.
Well, you probably, if you had that many, you'd have to get 8 or 10 bunches of greens to cover that many, maybe more.
So you're not going to do right and do this for us?
What?
Said you're not going to do right and replace it because we didn't get enough?
I'm doing you right. I sold you the greens and you bought them by the bunch. And they cooked down. I didn't guarantee them to feed 12 people or one person. You saw them when you bought them. I sell them. I've been selling turnip greens for, I don't know who you, where you're from or whatever your accent is, but you evidently don't know much about turnip greens or mustard greens.
Well.
But I'm not going to. I don't guarantee them to feed any amount. I don't sell them by weight. I sell them by the bunch, and you buy it by the bunch. And when you bought 3 bunches or 5 bunches or whatever you bought, that's what you got.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Well,
that's all I owe you.
Okay.
I mean, you paid me for them, and that's our transaction.
Yes, sir. Well, look.
You're the first person I've had in 20 years about the size of the greens now,
yes,
about
sir.
How I'm cooking down.
Yes,
everybody that's... Have you ever eaten turnip greens before?
Well, I just a spoonful that night. My wife is very upset about this.
Well, she needs to talk to some other people that are familiar with Southern cooking.
Yes, sir.
Cook turnip greens.
Yes, sir. Well,
I don't. That normally the people come in from Houston. A lot of them do for Thanksgiving and Christmas, and I'll sell some of them 15 or 20 bunches of turnip greens to feed their families.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, that's the way they're sold. But I sell them with turnips on them. And most of the ones that you'll see in the stores, you won't see any with turnips on them.
Yes, sir.
When you put the turnips on them, you're getting a premium product.
Yes, sir. Well, let me ask you this. I'm about to buy a motel here in town and also probably a convenience store. And my family has a lot of them and everything. And would you be willing to trade out some of your vegetables, and you could stay at my motel one night, or I could put some advertisements in.
What you're saying doesn't make sense to me.
Yes, sir.
So you got a hotel?
Yes, sir.
Where is it? Here in Nacogdoches?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. But would you be interested in...
No, I would not. I live here.
Oh, do you?
Got a house here.
Yes, sir. Okay. Okay.
My family's been here since 1836.
My goodness.
We've been here a long time. We've raised a lot of turnip greens.
Yes, I bet you
and
have.
I understand what you're saying. But you sound like to me that you're either Pakistani or you're Indian or something like that.
Yes, sir.
And I don't think you really knew, probably your wife didn't know what she was buying when she bought them.
Yes, sir.
Thought it was something else.
Yes, sir.
That's probably what happened.
Well, we don't feel like you did us right about it, but anyway.
My friend, I guarantee I sell it for the bunch. And she sold a bunch of greens. And she didn't realize that greens cooked down. But greens cook down, any kind of greens. You've got collard greens, you've got turnip greens, you've got mustard greens and all of that. But they're going to cook way down.
We just don't feel like we got the full value for the money.
I feel like you got what you paid for. That's correct.
Yes, sir. Well, I don't want to.
I think you can go anywhere you want to that people are knowledgeable about it and they will agree with it.
Well, don't make me have to call the police or something.
What?
You know, should I call the police about it or the way you're talking to me?
Call police. Do whatever.
I have my rights.
You got your rights, but she bought that by the bunch. And she got what she paid for. She paid me forever how many bunches she got. I go to the farmer's market, and I do it as a hobby, and I do it to accommodate a lot of people. And I don't really do it to make money out of the thing.
Yes, sir.
And you go talk to anybody you want to, the county agent or anybody that's got knowledge about it, and you'll find that she got what she paid for.
Well, I just find it funny that some...
The sellers can see how they sell them. They sell them by the bunch.
Some a large...
Go to butcher.
It looked like plenty for everybody to eat, and then it was just a handful when it was cooked, you know.
I can't help how they cooked down. I didn't cook the greens, so I don't know what they are.
Yes, sir. All right.
Okay.
All right. You have a good evening.
Okay, well, my name's George Miller.
All right, Mr. Miller.
I've been around Nacogdoches a long time. So
yes, sir. All right, Mr. Miller.
Okay.
Okay, bye-bye.